Hello everybody, welcome to my channel. Today we will be continuing the Victoria Moon picture that we started a little while ago. And as some of you can see, I actually have done some work since the last time. I actually got some tips that I'm supposed to put the diamond straight. So I did do some work, so as some of you can see, there is some work. And then you see the start of the cross and a little bit of the dragon's tail here and here. So I thought we'd start working on this area. See that I've done some of the frames. This little section here, this little square things are all 823s, which is I'll get out my 823s, which is number 5. No, 5 is 310, my mistake. This number is 310 because I got the legend right here, which tells you what the numbers are. And that little square is 27. This is 5, it's just 310. I will pour some into my bowl. Yes, I have my wax, I have my pens. And I got some tips on how to do this. You know, I'm not perfect at diamond painting yet, so no, it's still rather very new. This is like, I think, what, my 4th diamond painting? My first one was a partial, which was a unicorn, which I did as a live stream just to test it so I could see if I would like it or not. See, and those little things here, these are all A23s, these ones here. Those are the blue ones. But sometimes when you walk away from the diamond painting, it looks all kind of shiny. Each diamond painting is going to be different, but this is such a big project that I have to do it. A lot of this is probably going to be done off camera, but that doesn't mean we can not still do some stuff on camera. So, you know, I always you know, I've been reading, I've been doing some stuff, sorting through things, watching some Netflix. You know, I've been watching a lot of different things on Netflix. But, you know, I did watch Tiger King, and I just thought that that was absolutely one of the most insane things I've ever watched. In a weird way. I do like these pictures though. They do come out nice. You know, and I got some interesting tips after this video went live. So then I figured out, you know, what I was doing wrong in this. And it didn't feel like plucking off all the diamonds. Because once you pluck off the diamonds, you kind of tear off the glue on this. So I'm not going to do that. Just going to continue forward with what it is. Then pray I can get it. You know, going forward, I know now. Little bit more because I got some tips in it, and I want to thank those people who gave me those tips. You know, some people say, oh, well, bigger is better. I don't know if bigger is better. When it comes to diamond paintings. It's coming out, but if you guys want to see it, that's, you know, it's coming out. If you guys don't get to see the shine, but there is shine in this. So from far away, the shine will show up. Yes, phones ring. And then they become annoying. It's not my phone. They become very annoying. My mother had something that she needs to take care of because I just heard the door. Sometimes living with someone else is good because they remind you of things that you need to do. I always like this because it's always fun to, it's kind of like a puzzle you have to do in a way. And that's one of the things that I really have started to like about this. As I do this more and more, kind of been getting into it. You know, when I first started this, I didn't think I was going to like diamond painting. I was like, that looks tedious. But then I started doing one and I started really liking it. So then I was like, I like this. It's fun. Reminds me of a puzzle that you gotta figure out the numbers and then... I'm using my dragon pen on the dragon diamond painting, which I kind of find ironic. But you know, I like things like unicorns, dragons. Things like that are always fun. This is coming out really nice, actually. I'm sure this is going to be very nice when it's done. In some ways, I'm just a beginner. I'm not as, you know, when. You My other pens don't seem to do as well on this canvas. I don't know why. I don't know if it's a wax issue. I don't know if it's a glue issue. It's just the way that I put my drills in. Sometimes diamonds will pop off. You know, I thought when I first did this that this was going to be an easy piece. But I like different pieces. I like pieces that will keep me busy. Because then, you know, while we're doing all this, we have someone to listen to. You know, it's been a bit hard, you know, but it's also been very, very quiet. Like, I'm not used to it being this quiet. These ones that I left empty, that's a different color than the tray I'm doing now. I may need more wax. Gotta put more wax on my pen, my drill pen. I know, I was reading some stuff, you know, about things and things, but then someone asked me about this quarantine tag. I'm not going to do it. It sounds interesting. I have to see other people's videos, but I did see someone do a video of a quarantine book. Books, I guess, you color in during your quarantine. Doing this. this piece is very hard to get the drills in. I don't know why, but I am having a problem with it. I should have chosen something with not dark colors. I should have chosen something with lighter colors. Sometimes you have to reshuffle your diamonds or drills to get them. See how the painting starts to fill up. This is like, it looks okay on the screen, but when you're up close, it really is very, very tiny. So now I'm going to put more of this 310 in there. Don't worry, I have more in the other containers. I ran out of containers to put stuff in, so. It's a very unusual way to fit it in. This is just a very, very tight quarter. You know. See, every time you see this, this will be bigger than the last time, but I just want to show you that this is really glittery. You guys don't really get to see the glitter until I show it. No, sometimes that happens. You put the drill on and then it gets loose somewhere on the painting. Like trying to find it. Buried in all this stuff. Hold him. Then we'll do this section as well. It's always fun to do this, see what we can do with it. Sometimes that happens when you're putting in diamonds. Or the drills, as they're called. You see weed? I've been watching a lot of TV. I hope all of you have been doing good, keeping busy. Now, the thing about these paintings is that they take a long time to do some of them. Some of them are really tiny little finite things to do. And then I was thinking about all the, you know, I've been coloring. I've been also just trying to read when I can read. And I think I'm going to be doing some more cleanup. I've been cleaning a little bit here and there. no. The thing got stuck. No, the legend got stuck. That's really bad when the legend gets stuck in the paper. You guys don't see it, but you can hear it. Which is bad. The legend got stuck to this. I don't want to show you how badly it got stuck because I didn't keep a good eye on this thing. I should never put the legend on an open adhesive like this. Very bad way to do it. So I'm going to off camera, I'll fix that if I can get it off. So you know what, guys? I'm going to stop the video here and then we'll do another video later on, okay? Bye, everybody. Hello, everybody. Welcome much back to my channel. After that little mishap that we had, I managed to get a wet towel. You ever have that happen when you have a paper and it gets all sticky? Well, you take a wet little rag, a very little wipe, or a wet wipe, but a non-alcoholic wipe, and you take it and then rinse it off and then it'll help keep the painting intact. If you ever have that happen, I learned that the hard way. So this is number 27939. It's that little diamond with the little the triangle within the triangle is 939. So I'm gonna put 939 here. Put that in there, and so then we can go back to the painting. And so let's get back into the painting after that mishap. So we're going to try and do all the 939s within them. Let's do up to there we go. We do all these little tiny diamonds. All the diamonds are done nice and neat. You get it in and out really quickly. Like this. That's really pretty. Like when they fit perfectly in. This one, nothing fits perfectly. I don't know why. I don't know if the squares are too small. What's my alignment? But I'm having a hard time with the alignment, figuring out what belongs where. Like some of these pieces are just really tiny, and sometimes I can't even see it very well when I'm doing it, but if I do it, like if I was doing this at night, I wouldn't definitely need a light pad. Sometimes they go in perfectly and sometimes they do not on this canvas. I also seem to have some pop-up. You guys don't see it, but sometimes when I'm working on this at nighttime off-screen, I get a pop. Thank you. See, I don't like when the camera goes all like it goes in and then it goes out. For you guys to see what I'm doing. I really like these pieces, how they're all fitting in. They start to fit in. Start to see how it fits in. Well, just in the lower part of the painting. We're not even in the upper part of the painting yet. See, as you start to get them, they start to become less. And I thought I had ordered my coffee yesterday, and I didn't order it. I actually ordered the beans instead of the ground coffee, which was already grinded. So I don't feel so happy about having ordered the wrong thing. But I suppose it happens to all of us at some point. We all order the wrong thing, but you feel like, ugh. So you need to always see that the painting is coming along. Sometimes they get stuck. And they start to come in. I didn't see Briar Patch, so don't ask me about Briar Patch, because someone asked me about it on a stream. I did not watch that Rosario Dawson miniseries. My mother turned on the light switch, and so all of a sudden I had more light. Sometimes you think you have enough light. It turns out you don't have as enough light as much as you thought you did. If you hear a noise, that's just my mother putting things away. But it's just like been so weirdly quiet. Like at 7 o'clock, they start cheering for the healthcare workers here in New York City. So, I just have to be careful that I don't get the warning light on the camera. I think that's the thing I hate most about recording is that sometimes the machine goes off and you don't even look at it, so sometimes you have to look at your camera to see how much time you have left. So we have all these little the phone rings. You could... Never fails when you're doing something, the phone always rings. That's 27, but let's look at what this is. I have no idea what this is. I'm trying to figure out what this code is. Number 9, I think. Somebody can read this for me. Is that an S or is that an up signal? Like a tree. Dirty. Is number 30. See, sometimes trying to find a symbol is hard. See, even I have a hard time with some of the symbols in this. See, now I know what the symbol is. Sometimes you have to figure out what the symbol is because it's not so easy to figure out what the symbol is. Okay, guys, I gotta leave because the camera's telling me that my battery is dead. So have a wonderful evening, guys. But before we do that, I'm gonna zoom out just to show you how much we've done. The puzzle is full now. I just want to show you that glitter. This is very glittery. See, when it's done, you don't see it, but when you can see all that glitter. So I hope you all have had a good time, and hopefully I'll be back with more videos. And I'm just pouring the excess, the diamonds I didn't use, back into their proper container. So when you're done and paint, you want to be somewhat neat with this, because they happen to have little, they're little, and I don't want them getting messed up with anything else. So everybody have a good evening, or good afternoon, or good morning, or whenever you see this, and have a wonderful week, and everybody stay safe. And just be patient. We will get through this. Bye, everybody.